Hey everyone, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at the Gigabyte H610M H DDR4 motherboard. Now this board represents the lowest rung on the ladder for anyone looking to build a basic PC with Intel's latest 12th generation Alder Lake processors, where it's powered by the entry-level Intel H610 chipset. As the model name implies, this board offers DDR4 support, not DDR5, which should help to lower the overall cost of building a PC with this board. Before we begin, big thanks to CDL Trading, the authorised distributor for Gigabyte in Singapore, for loaning me this board for this video. With that, let's get started. First things first, the packaging. The H610M HDDR4 belongs to the budget-oriented ultra-durable series of motherboards by Gigabyte, placing beneath the mid-tier Gigabyte Gaming series and the top-of-the-line Aorus series of motherboards. As such, the H610M HDDR4 comes in a black and bronze colorway that has come to be associated with the ultra-durable series of boards. Now, moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual overview of specs for this board, nothing really fancy to call out here. We'll cover the board specs in depth in the next few minutes of this video. With that, let's get on with unboxing the board. Opening up the box, we see that Gigabyte has included two SATA 3 cables right here. Now let's get the board out of the way for the moment so that we can see what else has been included. Gigabyte also included an I/O shield, seeing as this board does not come with an integrated I/O shield design, and this is rounded off by a condensed version of the motherboard manual. Gigabyte has chosen to do away with the DVD driver disc, which I suppose won't be missed anyway, seeing as modern PCs don't come with an optical drive anymore. With that, onto the motherboard itself. And here we have it, the H610M H-DDR4. Gigabyte's gone with a light grey on black colour scheme with these angled motifs in the lower half of the board, which do spice up an otherwise plain looking aesthetic. Now, being an entry level motherboard, it does not come with an integrated I/O shield design, nor does it come with built-in RGB LEDs of any sort. Do note that the board does not come with VRM heatsinks, nor does it have a heatsink for the lone M2 drive slot. It does, however, have a small passive heatsink for the H610 chipset. For memory support, the H610M H-DDR4 comes with two DDR4 slots, not DDR5, with support for up to 64GB of RAM and the DDR4 3200 standard with plastic slots of a dual-tab design. USB 3 front panel connectivity is courtesy of a single USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header located right here next to the RAM slots. This header supports up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel USB Type-A ports. While still on the topic of USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two front panel USB 2.0 Type-A ports. In terms of expansion slots, this entry-level board comes with a single PCIe 4.0 x16 slot and a PCIe 3.0 x1 slot, with both slots made out of black plastic. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports, with all four ports in a straight-angled configuration. The board also comes with a single PCIe 3.0 x4 M2 slot, not PCIe 4.0, so this is something to take note of, especially if you're intending to use a PCIe 4.0 M2 SSD with this board. You might have noticed that Gigabyte's opted for a plastic latch instead of the usual metal screw and standoff arrangement to hold the M2 drive in place. Now, the position of the said plastic latch is adjustable so as to cater to different M2 drive lengths. For audio, Gigabyte has included a Realtek ALC897 audio codec, which is a very standard audio codec that can be commonly found in most lower-end motherboards. Internet connectivity, on the other hand, is courtesy of Realtek's 8111H chip, which provides support for standard gigabit Ethernet. Do note that the Ethernet chip that comes included with the H610M H-DDR4 varies according to the board revision number. This can be checked by simply looking at the revision number on the board right here, or checking the sticker that is stuck to the side of the motherboard box. Now for this particular board that I have right here, Revision 1.2, it comes with the Realtek 8111H Gigabit Ethernet chip like I mentioned earlier on, while the older Revision 1.0 comes with Intel Gigabit Ethernet instead. My understanding is that Revisions 1.1 and the latest 1.3 both come with Realtek Gigabit Ethernet parts as well. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 3 fan headers which are located in these regions of the board. Also included is a single 12V RGB header located right here. You're out of luck with this board if you need an addressable RGB header, as the H610M H DDR4 does not have one. Moving over to the rear I/O, the board comes with 2 PS2 ports right here, a VGA port, a HDMI 2.0 port that, according to the motherboard manual, supports a maximum refresh rate of 30Hz at 4K resolution instead of the usual 60Hz. We also get 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, an Ethernet port, as well as the usual audio jack connectors. To sum up, the H610M H DDR4 by Gigabyte is a basic Intel 12th Gen Alder Lake motherboard that is well suited for a low-end PC build, targeted perhaps at internet surfing and office productivity work. My take is that an Intel Core i3, Pentium Gold or Celeron will be right at home with this board. If you're intending to get a Core i5 and above processor, I'd recommend going for a board with a B660 chipset instead, as such boards would be better able to harness the potential of such higher-end processors, with features such as PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots, better power delivery solutions, and perhaps even 2.5Gb Ethernet. As of end June 2022, this board can be had for a price of around 159-ish Singapore dollars in Singapore, and this roughly translates to approximately $115 for you international folks. With that, thank you so much for watching, smash the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.